this tutorial, we're going to introduce the basics of the figure eight. Figure eight is the basically the holding pattern for team flying, and frankly, it makes a great holding pattern for individual flying. Now, by holding pattern, I mean a simple maneuver that you can do almost absent-mindedly with a little bit of practice. So it gives you something to do just to keep the kite in motion, as well as giving you a very basic flight path to follow your teammates around. So we're going to break it down a couple of different ways. The actual turn, so we've got an underturn figure eight, which goes like this. And then we also have an upturn figure eight, which goes like this. So in this regard, the kite is actually turning upward most of the time. So that's the one we're actually going to start you off with, because if you're a new or intermediate flyer, you're going to find that that is the easiest one to do for the simple reason that your kite is facing up most of the time. It's a very familiar kind of position. So the way we're going to do that again is we'll basically just fly around, and then we're going to come into the bottom right corner down here, and we're going to fly around this outside corner way up to the top, and then bank down across. We're going to repeat the same on this side. We'll turn up, fly around the outside, and then down through the center. So that's our upturn figure eight. And then the downturn figure eight, again, we head up to the top right corner, we turn underneath, down through the bottom, and straighten that diagonal line. Curve the outside here, and then on a straight diagonal line, curve outside, straight diagonal line. So those are the basic shapes, but the real trick to it is actually, surprisingly, adding a little bit of dual line input. So the simple thing is that normally when we turn the kite, we rotate, we squeeze down on the bottom and rotate off our index finger. And what that does is it gives you a pivot style rotation. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So I'll squeeze the bottom and it kind of spins around that axis a little bit. And it feels like maybe like there's grease on the track. When you're going around the figure eight, you might slide out, lose drive, and then have to reinitiate. So the way that we compensate that is by keeping our forward drive on, putting that same turn input, but pulling that same hand back a little bit. And what it does is it basically dumbs out the turn. It reduces the amount of pivot rotation that the kite can produce. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to fly to the top right, and you'll see me draw my right hand in while I make that turn. And here, my left hand I draw in while I'm squeezing down on that turn a little bit like a normal quad input. So squeeze and pull. Squeeze and pull. So again, if I just squeeze, it goes a little too tight. And if I only pull, it doesn't turn tight enough. So I use a little bit of both. And that gives me a really smooth under rotation. So we've talked about the basic shape, and we've talked about the basic controls. What we really want to do now is take that eight and fill up the whole window and give it a little bit of intent and direction. So what we're going to do is we're going to break it into a basic hourglass shape, and I'm going to demonstrate that here. So I'm going to fly to a top right corner. I'm going to fly all the way down to the bottom right corner, and then I'm going to face top left and go all the way up there, turn straight down, and then back up through here. So what we've got is a basic hourglass pattern. But what it allows me to do is set four points in the window that I always come to, and it helps me break down straight lines. So once more, I always come to the top corner. So no matter what's happened before me, I've got to get to that top point so there's plenty of room in the sky, down to this bottom point, right up through, to the other point, down to this point, and up through. So you can see, even though I flew a curved, proper figure eight, I still marked those four points, and that allowed me to fill the entire window consistently. So that's your basic introduction to figure eights. I encourage you to practice them heartily, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.